Previously on the Garner Brothers. For today's episode, we've decided to change up our format just a little bit.
Okay, everybody. So we're going to spin the wheel. But before we spin the wheel, let's tell you what's on the wheel.
This is it. Okay. This is our first spin.
Down to it.
Nitty gritty.
Who's got that one?
That's mine again.
Okay. Those things, you gotta. My time's up. My time's up.
3 minutes. Now, let's begin.
Time's up. So let's.
All right, let's do it. Oh, it is! Oh my gosh!
Okay.
Good. This is a good one, I think.
Who is? Wait, before I do this.
Oh, okay.
Who it is?
Okay, ostriches. We know because of Saturday morning cartoons that ostriches stick their heads in the sand when they want to avoid the problems they're facing. And we've seen that people are doing that to avoid, they're just sticking their heads in the sand to avoid the times of the signs, so to speak. And your thoughts.
The hard decisions.
Yeah,
I don't want to make those decisions.
They don't want to face them, so they'll think they'll magically disappear by putting their hands in the sand.
I agree. There are people out there that are doing that way too much, especially with all that's happening.
A lot of it has to do with personality. Some people just don't have that kind of personality. They don't want to dwell on those things. I think a lot of it has to do with circumstance. Some people are dealing with just so much right now that they don't want another worry. They don't want to worry about that too. Although the world's ending too. But and so I think they're trying to protect themselves, and that's the way that they've figured out how to do it is just not think about it.
And if you find yourself wanting to avoid thinking or studying or discussing the hard things that are going to happen, I'm afraid that if you do it too much, there's another pull that is going to pull you toward it, and that's the world. The world doesn't want you to study the signs of the times. The world doesn't want you to prepare for the second coming of Christ. So the world will pull you toward it and all its problems. And I think that studying the signs and understanding them at least a little bit will help with that.
All right. And I don't think studying the signs of the times is doomsday, like most people would say. What is it? They would call people like us.
Preppers?
Preppers, or you know,
perverts. That's what I thought Ryan said. They haven't called me that in a long time.
But I think they put a label on that just to, you know, make themselves feel better. But I think there are consequences for not knowing what's going to happen. This is a great time to prepare. Prepare spiritually, physically, emotionally, all the things.
And I think one of the reasons why they stick their head in the sand is they think that it's all bad. But it's not. There's a lot to look forward to. There's a lot.
I mean,
But it's all bad before that.
Yeah.
What am I doing in Mexico?
Bad stuff you gotta get through.
But that's what life is about. It's all about finding the joy in the sorrow.
President Nelson said, doesn't matter what the situation is, if we're close to the Spirit, we can still feel happiness.
You could have drawn that sentence out a little bit longer.
There's 3 seconds.
Happiness.
All right. Okay, I'm doing one rotation.
Plus one.
Mister. Mister.
Famous.
Okay. Right now, we've got a war in the Ukraine. High gas prices, out of control inflation, anticipated food shortages. So if you cannot see the importance of storing essential items now, then you are deliberately ignoring signs. You are an ostrich.
That's subscription.
Right, ostrich. You subscribe to the ostriches.
Just hit that like button and pound that.
So yes, we're talking about shortages, famines.
There was an article, I can't remember where, about a member of the church in Ukraine who was using his food storage to feed all the other people in his building or whatever like that, and it was good to see.
I love that. He wasn't hoarding it, right? He wasn't in his basement.
No, he was handing out.
Yeah.
He did. I don't remember much about what he had and what he was handing out. Didn't seem like a lot, but that's what it was there for.
That's awesome.
And it worked.
This has
nothing to do with food shortages that are coming, but it was cool to see.
This last summer, we did a series of videos about the famine. And what I'm realizing is that you can't just pinpoint, not this time in the world's history, you can't pinpoint these shortages on one thing. But we have the COVID shutdowns, you have the fires during the summertime, you have the war. I mean,
the bird flu. Like
what?
The bird flu.
We can't talk. That's one of the topics. There are many reasons. It's like a perfect storm and a perfect time, if you haven't already, to start stocking up on some cans of food. Glenn Beck always says, when you go to the store,
buy two of everything when you only need one.
Get two. Buy two instead of one.
Yeah, and when you do go to the store, you'll see, and I'm sure, I'm just preaching to the crowd here, that things that are normally there are not there. You know, the shelf is full over here, but the weird, like beans are gone, you know, or that's what I've noticed.
I've tried to get canned peaches at the Walmarts for months. The Walmart brand.
Oh, the Walmart, okay.
Not there.
Did you go to Walmart?
Yeah, the Walmarts. Oh. And they're gone.
Canned peaches are gross.
Well, they won't be when you have no other food. They'll be good.
Yeah, you'll be drinking that syrup straight out the can.
Well, maybe this is a good thing. You can't buy the canned peaches. Just go ahead and buy those canned pears.
Those are gone too? The pears and the peaches, they're all gone.
Okay, now we have a problem.
See, I'm telling you, there's a problem with the Walmarts.
All right, 8 seconds. Good enough.
Hey, I think 3 minutes is pretty spot on.
Yeah,
it is.
All right, here we go. What haven't we done?
Why don't we do a bow tie or the subscriptions now? Oh. Gotta break things up.
Okay, boom.
Oh. Okay, here we go.
What are we doing, bow tie?
Boat.
Oh, bow tie.
Oh, it's a bow tie. I can't believe we just landed on bow tie. Okay, so
I'll talk about bow ties for 3 minutes.
Is that a clip-on?
Bow tie.
Is that a clip-on?
I decided, it was my decision, okay, to put bow ties in that as a topic because I feel like this is an important thing we need to discuss. The question is, are bow ties a bad idea? Or a horrible idea.
Okay. I think it's a horrible idea if you have a big Adam's apple, because it then bobs every time you talk. Yeah, that's bad.
Oh, there was a sister missionary who had that problem.
What?
Wait.
So anyway, so bow ties. Really, I guess my problem with bow ties is it's just so different. I mean, we all know that we should be wearing a normal tie.
We all do?
We all know that. Everybody knows.
Everybody here.
Jason's staring at me with his bow tie. I mean, for me, it's a trust issue. Can I trust this person that's wearing a bow tie? Why is he wearing the bow tie?
Interesting.
It's we need to talk about it.
Those of us who are brave enough to wear bow ties, we all realize that bow ties get a bad rap. Orville Redenbacher. What's his name that always wears the bow tie? I'm not going to even say his name. But there is a difference. I understand that there is a difference between bow ties. If you wear a bow tie and it's a clip-on, I concur with what Blaine is saying. But no. Bow ties, they look better.
I'm trying to... Oh! it isn't.
No, this is a real tie.
Oh, wow.
I mean, it's not like me tied anymore because I'm not going to do it on camera. But, that feels good, though.
You can breathe.
Yes, but when you have the bow tie, you can see all of your buttons.
You can.
Yeah, nobody wrinkled, likes looking at buttons.
See, my son goes to church every Sunday wearing a bow tie.
Does he?
Every time.
Yes, wait, who?
Trent.
T-Rex.
Okay.
He's passing the sacrament in a bow tie?
Good for him. And I wore bow ties, you know, maybe 35 to 40% of the time to church every week or every month about until I got fat. And then you got to hide that fat with something. So you get a long, big old thick tie. Yeah.
It also hides your wrinkles if you didn't have time to press your shirt.
Oh, that's true. It does.
Nice.
That's true, because you put your jacket on.
Well, we both
it's not something that was made popular by French soldiers, and then the French elite is not something I can support.
Did you look that up?
I did. Oh. I did research. I didn't know how in-depth we had to go on bow ties. Oh, my gosh.
All right. Talking. Next
they didn't have a corduroy bow tie.
That is so cool.
Next. We already know what it is, right?
Is that the last one?
Description.
No, poultry. We haven't done
group reset.
Great reset, future wins, poultry.
Well, then we'll just spin it and go to
ostrich. Great reset. Great reset. Am I doing that?
That's you.
Oh, okay. Okay, 3 minutes on the clock. The great reset. Just like a week ago, I was talking with a friend, and I brought up the great reset, and he had no idea what I was talking about. And so I was surprised that he didn't know, because I can't escape it. Everyone's talking about the Great Reset. So, first of all, if you have not heard about the Great Reset, Google it. Or to save you time, just go to the World Economic Forum website and read for yourself what they say about the Great Reset.
Shocking.
It is very shocking. I mean, I knew that the world was going to burn before the second coming, but I didn't know it would be, you know, like this.
Right. Whether it gets to that point or not, you can see where these people's heads are at. They want control. They want power.
Well, they already have it. That's why they're able to implement all this stuff. That's why they're able to do it. They're not waiting for anybody. They're just moving ahead. They're doing it.
Yeah, they're not even hiding what they wanted.
We want to take all your stuff. You will own nothing. And you will like it.
By 2030.
You will say thank you.
Yeah, you'll say.
May I have another? You're
gonna have. And that goes back to the family. Mm. If your family owns nothing, you're not required to produce anything. You're not required to provide for your family. That's another indication and another way that they can degrade the family. I also saw that, like the wicked do, they like to change the names and definitions of things when it behooves them.
And now, no longer the knights who say.
And I saw the other day that weird old guy from with the German accent.
Klaus Schwab.
Yeah. He was talking about the fourth industrial revolution, which is another word, another term for the Great Reset. Mm-hmm. So I think they might be, because it's everywhere, because people are talking about it, and because it's that word and there's books now, I think they might be trying to shift the definition over to something else so it's a little more palatable for everyone.
So would you say that they're resetting the family? What are they? That's what I've always wondered. What is it?
I think they're trying to take away our agency. Yep. I mean, one of the first things the Savior told Adam after the garden was, your Heavenly Father, you're supposed to work. The earth isn't going to produce spontaneous now. You need to get out there and you need to work. And they're trying to take that away. They're going to give you everything you need, and they're going to take care of you and do everything according to what they want, and they're going to take away our agency, our...
And there are some where that does sound fantastic. Some people think that would be great, but it's not.
It's not part of the plant.
Look at that.
That's it. You can't talk about it anymore.
Nope.
Oh, look at that.
Man, it's me again.
Right on.
Okay. All right, fine.
You're going to get through all of them.
All right, so this topic is called poultry, the bird flu. Another thing, if you have not heard about what's going on these past 2 months, Google it. There is a bird flu. Actually, I wrote some notes. Dang it. I'm cheating. There's some interesting things going on, and I wanted to read them. So starting February, there have been 17 million birds killed in the United States. In the United States. And that was 2 weeks ago.
Was it by windmills?
No. These are actually the government forcing farmers to kill their birds because of this outbreak, bird flu.
Chickens and turkeys.
Chickens, turkeys, yes. Yeah. Thank you. So there's an outbreak. The majority, most of the United States have seen this outbreak within their state boundaries. The former CDC director says that this will be the next pandemic, and it will be more deadly. They said 60% death rate. Yeah, and then you have the government putting their hand in all of this and saying, you know, if you have a flock of birds, whatever, if it's turkeys or chickens or whatever, if one contracts the bird flu, then all of them are to be killed. And that includes these huge farms that have 500,000 birds. They're all, and it's been happening, which is why it's climbed up to 17 million chickens dead. And that's just in the last 2 months. So if you've seen prices rise up in poultry, whether that's eggs or chicken, that's why.
That's scary.
Wow, obviously planned, right? Some people call it the plandemic.
Well, I, on my way into work today, I drove by my neighbor's house. They have a bunch of chickens. Not one of those chickens had a little tiny mask on.
Oh, my gosh.
It's absurd.
Did you call the CDC?
They don't have the little ones. They don't have ears. How are they supposed to keep them on?
So I also, we have 40 seconds left. We don't want to scare you. I mean, this is a good time to prepare.
But what about, I mean, yeah, the chickens are getting the bird flu.
Can versus fur.
Can I get the bird flu? How do I get the bird flu? By kissing a chicken?
According to the people who are in the know, it can get to that point. I don't know if it has yet. I think if it had, we'd all know about it.
Yeah.
But what they're saying is that it has the possibility of transferring to humans, but
it's
it hasn't.
It's like all flus.
By eating chicken.
And that is why the government's getting involved in killing them, killing your whole...
Mouth
by touching their feces? By what is it? How does it spread?
I don't know. But now is a good time. If you can some chicken.
Nope.
Oh, we're out. Yep. We're out of time. Okay.
There are other things you need to do, but we're not going to tell you.
We can't tell you.
Subscriptions. All right. We thought that it would be interesting and even helpful for us to briefly discuss some of the YouTube subscriptions that we have that we value and think are good. I'm just going to start off by naming a few of them. First of all, the one that I probably spend the most time listening to is Halverson, because they're always so long.
What is it called? Unshaken.
Unshaken.
So good.
I listen to several photography ones. Peter McKinnon, he's fantastic. And then I listen to the Blaze or Glenn Beck stuff as well. I have so many. Now I'm going to turn the time over to John.
I have exactly one subscription. I think it's plain.
Not even subscribe to our own channel.
Not even. Yeah, I get blown about by every wind of doctrine when I go on Facebook or on YouTube. So I don't know. I just don't do it. Oh, you know why? Because I feel like when people tell me, you know, click the like and subscribe.
Smash the like button.
Yeah, smash it. I feel like what's his face? Ron Swanson, who says when somebody tells me to do something, I don't want to do it.
No.
That's why I don't do it.
Did you throw your computer in the dumpster?
Yeah.
I just think about him trying to eat that banana. I'll put that clip
smashes
on.
Smashes it in.
Ladies. Mm-hmm.
hamburger. Oh man.
You wanna?
I'm just gonna give you my top nine. Ambient worlds. It's just a music, background music thing that we always have music on in our house. The two, Micah, shout out. Tabernacle Choir, Temple Square, How Ridiculous, The Daily Wire, Blaze TV, The Chosen, and Retired at 40, which is a freeze drying channel. I have a freeze dryer.
I think I'm too liberal with the subscribe button. I see a good video, subscribed.
I love they must guy. Make a lot of good videos.
I don't need to see another video. I just love them. Yeah, so that's a problem. I'll just name a few. I listen / watch to what you guys watch too as well. I love Unshaken. The two used to be the two LDS archives.
Ergo. Etc. Etc.
It's called The Two now. City Prepping. You didn't mention City Prepping.
Oh, City Prepping. I do watch that. He's got a lot of good stuff, but he produces so many videos. It's a lot of the same stuff. So
right. Right. There's a lot of good ones. Let me say these guys. The Quack Brothers. I don't know. I like Graham Steven a little bit. I watch it every once in a while. Ice Age Farmer. That's if I were to recommend any. I would recommend him. He is so good. Ice Age Farmer. The Ice Age Farmer. Of course, the two brothers.
Time.
The two brothers. Oh.
Two brothers.
Two brothers. Oh,
I got lots.
I think we're done.
I just showed everybody in the world.
No, what we have one more. I think.
Gardening is cool.
Gardening is cool.
Oh, man.
I need to learn. I need to. Okay, here it is. This is the one.
Have we done? What? Do we need to check these?
Hey!
Wow, that was a great spin.
Yeah, it was. Landed on our last one.
First try.
Who's gardening is cool?
Batman. Lego Batman. Is it really?
Yeah, you have to.
What did it replace? Oh, okay. Gardening is cool.
It's cool now.
Discuss.
3 minutes, let's go.
We all gardened before it was cool.
And there's some lovely filth down here. Oh! How'd you do?
Actually, I don't do a lot of gardening. My wife does. I don't know anything about it. She knows almost everything about it. I just haul the manure where she tells me to and dig holes where she tells me to. But it's great to have all that food that we can eat and have and not have someone tell us what we can or can't have and then to freeze dry the extra. So gardening is cool. Discuss.
It's cool now. I mean, I've just seen, I mean, we're all, you know, trying to garden now.
Yeah. We have plots of land.
Huge tracts of land.
We've all selected our vegetables and fruits that we want to eat from our garden. But I've also seen outside of just us four, I've seen others that are trying at it now. And you know, tip of the hat to those who have been doing it for years. My goodness, thank you for being that voice that we can, or that fountain of knowledge that we can go to. But we're all trying to plant some potatoes and blueberries and
I decided this year, I've been prompted that I need to start, and I just haven't. And so this year I decided I'm doing it.
Of all the people you have,
we have a lot of room for a garden. We don't have the soil, but you know, we can get around that. But then I'm all ready. I've got raised beds. I've got seed potatoes. I've got other things that we're ready to do. And then it snows a foot on April.
What was it?
April springtime.
April 11th or something like that. So luckily I had procrastinated enough to not put my stuff in the ground yet. But yeah, I think it's very important and I'm very excited. Now this year, I think this might be helpful to some people, and I don't know if this is a good thing or not, but this year I am focusing on potatoes. I'm not a big gardener, but I'd like to be. So I'm gonna start with one crop this year and see how it goes.
I was thinking that this was a question. Is gardening cool?
No, it should be gardening is cool now.
Period. Oh, it is? Yeah. Well, I'm going to say, is gardening cool? I would say even though people are starting more and more to do gardening, I don't think it's cool yet. I think once the famine starts and stuff hits the fan, then gardening is going to be real cool. So get good at it now. So.
And if you have no idea where to start, just do one thing. Start, go on YouTube and
Speaking of subscriptions, Epic Gardening is a great subscription.
No, that's it. You can't even explain that. All right, how do we end this? So,
we'll do an end with the.
Let's spin it out.
We do.
We should sing it.
Yeah, one more spin.
Let's see.
And then we put our montage on.
What I say unto you, I say unto all, watch.